Hello and welcome you all in this video tutorial. Dear students, we are discussing about chapter number 4, and in previous videos we have discussed so many examples of img tag, how to create list, and in previous video only I told you about html links. So html links is of two type, internal linking and external linking, and in previous video we have seen the example of external linking. Now in this video we are going to do the example of internal linking. Dear students, as you all know, internal linking means when you click on that link, you may navigate or you may jump to another web page. But in internal linking, when you click on that particular link, you will jump on the same page of different topic. Like suppose sometime what will happen, on a browser we are getting a scroll, and through internal link we don't have to keep on doing the scroll. As you click on the link, internal link, what is the advantage of this? As you click on internal link, it will directly jump to the section or that part whatever you want to search. So internal linking means you are not going to jump on any other page, but on the same page you may jump to another section or another topic whatever you want to search. So let us try how to create internal link. Let me open Notepad. Okay, now before starting this, I told you for creating links we are using anchor tag, that is A. So here I am going to start HTML head title internal links title close, head close, body start, busy color is equals to green, next for internal linking you need some points, some topic, so that topic we are going to take with the help of list. So here I am starting OL list, next LI, like input device. This example earlier we did. Next UL, LI keyboard, LI mouse, LI you may take scanner. Next UL close, LI output, device. Next again UL, LI monitor, LI printer, LI plotter. Next UL close, OL close. Now dear students, if you want to create an internal link, suppose you want to see the information about keyboard, so how you will do? how to create internal link. So keep this one inside a tag, and here attribute href is equals to double quote, put this sign hash sign, hash sign like this, hash keyboard double quote close, and here same this keyboard control C, and here keyboard a tag close. Now if you want to same, you want to create a link for this also, so a tag href is equals to double quote hash mouse, copy this one, control C, double quote close, bracket close, control V, A. Next, this also, a tag href is equals to double quote hash sign scanner, copy this, double quote, a close. So this, these all you are creating internal linking. How to call this internal linking, that we are doing below of this list. Next, output device, if you want to create link for this also, to anchor tag href is equals to double quote hash sign, copy this, monitor, control C, double quote close, B, A close. Next, again A href is equals to double quote hash sign, close this here. Now here printer anchor tag close. Next, for this also if you want, then a tag href is equals to double quote hash sign, double quote close, plotter, a tag close. Now so these all you create external link, and to call this, these all external link, we need to do one thing more. After this list, try to create some gap like br tag. I mean, simply here I am using br tag. Why? Because on web page we are not having so many content. So for this, for using this br tag, I want to create some lines, blank lines, through which I am getting a scroll on the web page. That's why I am using here br tag. Or if you are having content, then paste that content like this. Next, suppose here you want to call that keyboard. So what you need to do, again a tag name is attribute of this a tag to call that particular points or topic, through which by clicking on that particular point you may navigate here. And this spelling, be very careful, whatever you are using at the top, the same spelling you have to mention here also. It means as you written here, the same you need to mention here also, like this. Close. Next, here h1, here give some message, description about keyboard, a h1 close. Okay, till here just try to see you are getting output or not. So for this I close here body tag, html tag, Now open this folder. Now just see your file is here only. Example 4. Now try to run it. Open with Internet Explorer. Now just see, when you click on this keyboard, see, you are jumping to description about keyboard. It means if you are having a scroll on a web page, so by clicking on internal link, you directly jumps to that section wherever you want. So like this. Next, if you want to create links for rest all devices, so for this what you need to do, go inside the code. Just copy this complete BR. Why I am using BR? Because here I want to create a scroll on a web page. That's why I am using BR. If you don't want to use BR, to write the content anchor tag A, name is equals to mouse, mouse, double quote close here, h1 here. You may write description about mouse, h1 close. Next, for the same, if you want to create next, a name is equals to, suppose, scanner, double quote close, h1 description about scanner, h1 close. Now just save it and go to the browser and see you are getting the changes or not. Now description about mouse, scanner. Now description about scanner. It means your links are working. Next, the same thing if you want for this monitor, printer and plotter, then the same thing you need to do. A name is equals to monitor font color is equals to, you may use this also, font color is equals to red, size is equals to 22, description about monitor font close. Next, control V. Suppose here a name is equals to that device name, whatever device we are using at the top, description monitor printer. So here you need to mention what printer name is equals to printer, double quote here, h, you may use font also, font color is equals to blue, size is equals to 22, close, description about printer font close. Now just see the changes, refresh it. Now click on keyboard, you are jumping on that keyboard section, monitor. Just see here, you are on description about monitor. Next, printer, description about printer. So like this your links are working. So this way we can create internal linking. Now just be very careful, br tag I am using here to generate a scroll on a web page, a scroll in the sense this one. And in place of this scroll, suppose you are having content over there and you want to switch and you don't want to use this scroll, you want to directly get the information about the related terms. So for this, internal links are very much useful. Hope you will understood. Next example, we are going to do how to insert audio and video on a web page. So for this, dear student, first of all, whatever audio and video file you want to insert inside your web page, keep that audio video file and your code in a same folder like this. I created already a folder. I'm having already a folder on my desktop here, IMG example, and I keep that audio and video file here. See, audio one and video file. So you also do in the same way, so that you don't have to provide the complete path of this audio and video file if you keep this in a same folder. So let us try how to do. HTML head title audio title close head close body. Inside body, if you want to use color, then you may use color also, or if you want to use background image, then you may use background image also. Background is equals to img1.jpg. this file I'm having in that folder, so that's why I'm using here. Next, if you want to display any message, so h1 tag, use center tag, center, next h1, and here you want to display any message, audio file. Suppose h1 close, center, or keep this center, close it at last. Again anchor tag href. Here you have to provide the link of that audio file, audio1 dot, give the extension also mp3, and here click to play audio, anchor tag close, at last center close, body tag close, html close. Now just try to save it in that folder, audio.html. Now go inside that folder. Now just see your file is here or not. audio.html, again open audio.html, just see your file is here. Try to run it, Microsoft as okay. Now audio file, click to play audio file. Now just click, now just see your audio is playing. So like this, you may insert audio. Now the same way you can insert video file also. Let us do how to insert video file. The code are same, nothing you have to change. Only what you need to change here. Now just see what is the name of that video file. Video 1 and video 2 I am here having here. So video 2. Open the code and write here video 2 dot mp4 and here click here to play video file. If you want to make it bold, for this size is equals to 18. Font. Let's see it will work or not. Go to the inside this folder, close it, minimize it, open this folder and again click on this Microsoft Edge. Now click to play video file. Now click. Now this, see, this is your video file, whatever you have inserted. So this way you can insert audio file and video file on a web page. And if you want to change, or if you want, suppose at the top if you want to insert some image, this already we have done. Suppose here BZ color is equals to pink, here IMG SRC is equals to img1 dot jpg, border is equals to 3, height is equals to 20%, width is equals to 100%, close. Now go and check how it will appear. Now see, as you click here the video is going to be started. So this way you can insert and modify your page as you want.